All right, so today we are going to start with our next lecture session, that is regarding the fuzzy connectors. We have already done the fuzzy connectors in the earlier session, but this is just a expansion of this earlier session in which we took the connectors and the numerical according to that particular connector. Here we are going to work on with the if-then statement. Right, we are going to understand how we are going to use if-then statement and what actually does it mean, and then we are going to solve a question regarding that. Now see, when we have CRISP logic, if you remember, in CRISP logic what we did, we said that whenever we have an operator that is called as implication, this is the sign of implication. Okay, so whenever we have an operator as implication, it represents something. What does it represent? It represents if then statement. So if at all you just see the operator implication, that simply means or that simply represents if then statement. It is same as in CRISP logic and it is same as in fuzzy logic. So whatever we are doing in CRISP logic, here fuzzy logic has the same concept of implication. Now we are going to understand how we develop a relation between the two variables in which we have a implication operator. See, first thing, this is the first scenario. If X is A, then Y is B. We all know that this is a if then statement, because we are using if a condition exists, then the second condition will also exist. This is what it means. So if X is A, then Y is B. So how we are going to write it in the form of a relation? We are defining the relation in terms of, or we are denoting it with the R. So this is a relation for the if then statement. What does it say? It says that A Cartesian product of B, union of negation A Cartesian product with Y. Now, this is what the relation defines. In this, we all know we have A as a fuzzy set, we have B as another fuzzy set. We are going to take the Cartesian product of the both, and then negation of A is just the opposite of A. That means 1 minus A will be negation A into Y. Y is the universe of discourse here represented. So that is what we have to remember. This is the formula for the relation when we define if-then statement. Okay. Now, how do we write it in the form of membership function of R? Because we all know in fuzzy logic, how do we define the specific set? We define the specific set with the help of the membership function. So how we use to represent the membership function in the, with the denotation of mu, right? Mu of whatever the set is. Here we have the R, that is the set. So mu R of whatever the variables. Now see, we are going to find out mu r x comma y. Why x comma y? Because we have the variables out here as x and y, right? So what it will be? We all have studied that whenever we are going to find the Cartesian product, it is kind of an intersection. It is kind of an intersection of two sets. So when we define the intersection of two sets in the fuzzy, what we use minimum function. So we have minimum of mu a x comma mu b y. If at all you do not remember these formulas and these operations, you can refer to my earlier lecture sessions regarding the fuzzy logic and their concept and their operations. There I have already explained all these things. So for A Cartesian product B, what is the formula for this? In the terms of membership function, it will be minimum of mu A X comma mu B Y, right? This is for A into B. Now next we have this a negation. How do are we going to find the a negation? We are going to find it with the help of 1 minus mu ax. This will be what? This will be represented as mu. This will be represented as negation a formula. Fine. So now we have to find out the union of both these. This is a into b. This is negation a. Now I have to find the union of both. Now, if you remember, we have already done the operators in which we have said that the union will give the maximum. So for union operator, we use maximum function. So maximum of a into b, this formula, comma, negation a, this formula. So this is what we get as the final formula to find out the if then statement in which we have if x is a, then y is b. It is very simple. Only what you have to do, you have to put the formulas in terms of relation. Relation, you have to remember a into b, union, negation a into y, where y is universe of discourse. Fine. We are going to put it in the terms of membership function. Now, this was a simple statement, if then statement. We have another statement that is a compound statement. Now, how does this compound statement defines? It states, if x is a, then y is b, else y is c, right? Here, what is the difference? This was a simple statement and this is a compound statement because else condition is also there. So what are we going to do here? We are going to define the relation in terms of this as r is equal to a into b union negation a into c. The only difference is here you are using y as universe of discourse, while here you are going to use the next set, that is c. That's all the difference is. Otherwise, it's completely same. Right? So doing the same concept, representing in the terms of membership function of R. So how do we define it? Mu R x, y is equal to a into b is what? Minimum of mu A x comma mu B y. How do we find the negation A? Negation A I can find as 1 minus mu x. And how we write C? We can write C as mu C y. And as it is again Cartesian, negation A into C. So that is why we have to find the minimum of it. And then finally, we have union. So for union, we use the max operator. Fine. So what it will be? It will be the complete formula as maximum of minimum mu x comma mu b y comma minimum of y minus mu a x comma mu c y. Right, now we'll just see how we are going to solve the question regarding this. It is x is equal to a, b, c, d. A is equal to a comma 0, b comma 0.8, c comma 0.6, d comma 1. We have b set, another fuzzy set, 1 comma 0.2, 2 comma 1, 3 comma 0.8, 4 comma 0. C as 1 comma 0, 2 comma 0.4, 3 comma 1, 4 comma 0.8. And lastly, Y. Y is what? It is the universe of discourse with all the elements in this particular set, right? So now what we have to determine, this is the question, we have to determine the implication relations of the first part is the simple statement, if X is A, then Y is B. And the second one is the compound statement, that is if X is A, then y is b, else y is c. So what was the formula for this one? If you remember, it was r is equal to, we are going to find out the relation, r is equal to brackets a into, that is the Cartesian product, b, both are fuzzy sets, we all know, right? Union of what? The negation of A, right? Cartesian product with universe of discourse, that is Y. And now we are going to represent in the terms of membership function and then we are going to solve it numerically. So how it goes? It goes as, I have already told you what is the relation. This is the relation we are going to get. And this is the formula we are going to get. We have already seen how we are implying this formula. Now, what I have to do is I have to you know, first of all, calculate this set, then I have to calculate this set, and then I'll do the union of both these. So first fuzzy intersection will be A into B. It will be defined as A intersection B, because I have already told you A into B is what? It represents the intersection. So intersection is defined as minimum. So minimum of AX and mu BX. Similarly, the second intersection will be negation A into Y. Negation A intersection YX, that will be minimum of mu AX and mu YX. How we are going to see it as this one. See, the matrix will be formed. In this, we are going to find the A and B. This is A set, fuzzy set. This is B fuzzy set, right? So out of these, you all know what is, how is the matrix multiplication is done. We are going to see that. First of all, we are going to define it. This is X. These are the values of X as A, B, C, D, and Y values as 1, 2, 3, 4 on the universe of discourse. So this is the matrix we are going to implement. Now see, in this we have, what we are going to do is first element and first element of B. So we are going to find the minimum. So minimum of AX and minimum of BX out of 0 and 0.2, which one is minimum? 0 is minimum, so 0 is written. Then again, out of this and this, which one is 0, 1, which one is minimum? 0 is minimum. Similarly, as 0 is minimum, it will be find out with all the values as minimum. With 0.8, 0. With 0 and 0, again it will be 0. So I have reached as the first row with this. Now again, I'm going to find out the second row. How to find out the second row? Now I'm going to take this one. I'm going to compare 0.8 with 0.2. Right? So which one is minimum? 0.2 is minimum. 0.8 with 1, so which one is minimum? 0.8 is minimum, so 0.8 and then 0.8, both are same, so 0.8 is minimum, taken as 0.8 and 0, so which one is minimum? 0 is minimum. So this is the second row. Now the third row, we are going to compare the 0.6 with all these. So 0.6 compared with 0.2, I get 0.2. 0.6 compared with 1, 0.6, 0.6 compared with 0.8, 0.6, 0.6 compared with 0, so minimum is 0. So I get the third row. Now, fourth row, I'm going to compare 1. So 1 will be obviously greater with all these. So the same points will be written as 1 and 0.2, sorry. I find out 1 and 0.2, 0.2 is minimum, right? Then we have 1 and 1, 1 is taken. 1 and 0.8, 0.8 is minimum. And 1 and 0, 0 is minimum. So this is what we get as A into B matrix. Fine. So I have already reached this point. Now I'm going to find out the value of this one. So how do we find out the value of this one? Again, I'm going to compare it with the A negation. I have to find out A negation. A negation will be, just see, A negation will be 1 minus 0, 1, comma, 1 minus 0.8, 0.2. This is the matrix of A negation. Then 1 minus 0.6 will be 0.4. And 1 minus 0 will be, 1 minus 1 will be 0. So this is what A negation is, the set A negation. Now I have to create the Cartesian product with the YX. So YX is all we all know is 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm going to find out, we all know Y is 1, 2, 3, 4 as shown in the earlier set. I can show you it. This is the Y. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, we have already seen that you can just analyze in every case which values will be smaller, which values will be minimum. The values with the A negation will be minimum because these are 1, 2, 3, 4. So we are going to find out the same way as we have find out this particular matrix. So then I'm going to find out this A negation into Y matrix, right? Then what we have to do? We have to do the union of these two matrix, right? Because in the relation, we have what? We have A into B union negation of A into Y. So I have find out A negation, A into B, A negation into Y. Now I'm going to do the union. For union, I have to find out the maximum. So see, to find out the maximum, how will I get it? I have taken the two matrix. You can see this zero compared with one. Which one is maximum? One is maximum. You can see in A row, both the sets, one is maximum in all the cells. So one is maximum in all the cells. I have taken as this one. Next, we have B as 0.2. 0.2 compared, 0.2 will be written. 0.8 and 0.2, 0.8 will be maximum. 0.8, 0.2, 0.8 will be maximum. And 0, 0.2, 0.2 will be maximum. So it will be 0.2, 0.8, 0.8, and then, sorry, this one should be 0.2 and 0.2. Okay, this is the one. Next we have C. I'm going to again find out the maximum, 0.2, 0.4. So it should be 0.4, 0.6, 0.4, 0.6 should be there. 0.6, 0.4, 0.6 should be there. 0, 0.4, 0.4 should be there. So 0.4, 0.6, 0.6 and 0.4. So this is the third row. And similarly, I get the last row, that is the D. So finally, what is this? This says that T implies B is equal to what? Maximum of 1 minus TA comma TB, right? So this is how we represent it with the values. So thank you very much. I hope you must have understood this. This is enough for today.